Black Widow stars Deborah Winger is a data analyst for the Justice Department who stumbles across a suspicious pattern in the sudden deaths of two millionaires, and she starts to suspect that the same woman may have killed both men for their money. Comparing photos of the widows in the cases here, she becomes convinced that a crime has been committed, and she talks her boss into allowing her to investigate. And here she follows her suspect, played by Teresa Russell, to Seattle, but waits too long to prevent the death of the next victim.
I was in the room with him. He was 4 feet away from me.
And what were you supposed to do?
I don't know. I should have told him.
And he'd have believed you.
He would have had a chance.
Determined not to make the same mistake twice, she follows Russell to her next target in Hawaii and becomes friendly with her suspect.
You really like those things?
My second husband was addicted.
Second husband? How many have you had?
Lots. That's how I got rich.
Once wasn't enough to get rich.
Rich is hard. You never really figure you're quite there.
There's a real undercurrent of attraction between those two women. The investigation turns into a game of cat and mouse because Winger knows, and Russell knows she knows.
Black Widow. She mates and she kills. Your question is, does she love? It's impossible to answer that. Unless you live in her world.
I love the looks in their eyes there as they're looking at each other. Black Widow has great chemistry between those two women, but oddly enough, that's one of the problems with this film. There are a few scenes that unmistakably suggest that Winger is mesmerized by this strange woman that she's tracking, and I expected a nice cynical twist at the end of the film with the cop, Winger, beginning to identify with the killer. Instead, Black Widow uses a much more conventional thriller plot and a more predictable ending. The mistake, I think, was to suggest that close emotional bond between the two women and then not follow up on it and exploit it. I thought we were going to get a bizarre psychological thriller, and instead what we have here is a fairly clever police movie. I like the performances, especially Russell's. She plays four phony women and one real woman underneath, but I didn't like him enough to recommend the movie.
Oh, and I love this movie.
You did?
I think it's spectacular because, Roger, all the psychological twists and turns that you were playing around in your mind,
yeah,
that's fun to play around with your mind. Whether they come off or not is immaterial because the movie fooled you to a degree, or disappointed you, what you're saying, and the movie fooled me. I don't get fooled in thrillers very often. I was completely fooled in the film. I don't want to get any way, we can't get anywhere near telling the audience about how I was fooled. But I was fooled. I loved both of these performances. These are two of our very finest actors. It's a terrific comeback film
Bob Ravelson. I was fooled too. And I'll tell you why I was fooled. I was fooled because I expected this movie to do something different at the end. I was hoping for that. I was hoping it would go back to the tradition of those movies in the 1940s, the ones that kind of shy away from the evil side of human nature, and then at the end you realize these people can be bad as well as good. Instead of that, at the end of the movie, it was phoned right in. I'm telling you,
the ending
was a real disappointment.
Not to me. Really? It was thrilling, and I'm telling you that there is an undercurrent of attraction there because, and it has to do with being able to love. And Winger realizes that Teresa Russell has the ability to love at some perverse level that Winger does. Oh, yes.
You got that right out of here, Gene. You didn't get it from the screen.
That's where I get all my ideas.
That's
it's right out of here, baby.
That's your rewrite of the movie. It's not up there.
No, that's what I saw. The movie is what I saw, just like it is what you saw. And it's a great one.